making our way into the park now. It looks real small, real humble. Get a look at the prices right there. It's actually pretty cheap, not bad. All right, inside the park now, and this is really cute. One of two Hopkins looping coasters left in the country. These super classic trains, look at these. All right, here we go.
All my exes live in Texas, and Texas is a place I dearly love to be. But all my exes live in Texas, and that's why
now for this weird Vekoma family coaster. I don't even know what to make of this really. It looks like Blue Hawk at Six Flags Over Georgia, but just like a smaller scale. All right, go book back row. Hornet Boogie.
It's so slow. There's no air time.
Yeah, there's really no air time. That was super weird and super pointless. Even the restraints were super weird. It was like a bobsled, but a twist. I don't know. We're not doing that again.
No way, Jose.
No way, Jose. We're going to Texas Tornado again. We're going to get some night rides on that. Okay, but if this isn't the coolest souvenir cup ever, I don't know what is. You like it, Bean?
I love it.
Reminds me quite a bit of like a fun spot or a ZDT's or really just like an overgrown carnival. You always get like a lagoon vibe as well. I'm really enjoying it personally. That thing is just so funky and janky and just fun. It runs like a Schwarzkopf in how much intensity it has. You go in that first drop and you just hit straight track and you get whipped into this inversion. It really does feel like a Schwarzkopf inversion with all the positives. You hit these weird floater airtime hills and then you hit this just insanely intense turnaround before you hit another, again, positive filled inversion, and then you get like this weird tunnel before you hit another, like the weirdest floater airtime hill I've ever experienced. This thing is so weird, so janky, but it's so fun. You've got to come out and give it a try at least once.